But when you're training as an athlete, everything you do can make a difference.
The first ever Youth Olympic Games has been defined by sporting excellence and a thirst for knowledge. To reach your peak, every athlete needs to understand the science of performing to your best, and that means living a healthy lifestyle. This is at the heart of the cultural education program.
Especially at a young age, we have to continue to build our bodies, and you do that by putting the right building blocks inside through the right proteins and balance of carbohydrates so that you have that energy in order to be able to train properly and also to recover as well.
You know, I like to spend 5, 10, 15 minutes just kind of loosening my body up, stretching out a little bit to make sure that I'm ready to do whatever my body's asking me to do in workout. I started at a young age, and you know, once you get into a pattern, you get into a rhythm that you really don't even have to think. It's just, I know exactly what to stretch, I know exactly how to stretch it.
It's like more of choosing what's right before, during, before, after the competition. We thought we'd eat like those nutrition bars before the competition, not during, because they don't like many artificial things, but then they turn out to be very important during competition, so yeah, we've learned a lot.
I heard a great quote once. It was, your diet can make a good athlete great, but it can also make a great athlete good. So it can go either way.
Well, it's kind of hard, but you have to balance what you eat. You can't eat certain stuff because your muscles don't have enough energy and carbohydrates. So you need to balance the diet.
I mean, nutrition's massively important, so you've got to eat well, you've got to eat at the right times, you've got to eat the right things. It's about them eating their carbohydrates at the right time, i.e. pre-competition, and their proteins after competition.
The Health Zone was a crucial discovery workshop inside the Youth Olympic Village, exploring every ingredient that helps an athlete perform to their very best.
And I interacted with the Trinidad and Tobago football team. I was first asking them what they thought I should take before my judo competition, during my judo competition, after my judo competition, and they were quite right about it. So I need power, I need endurance, I need something to drink.
But most sports carry the same thing. It's just some sports need more protein than others and carbohydrates. But most of them carry the same thing.
On the evening before, I take a spaghetti.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, it's good, I think.
And you can put this on top here.
You can have a fruit anymore.
Thank you. Thank you for the fruit.
It's not just about your diet. Keeping your body hydrated is just as important. And it's a fine balance.
The very important thing when you are an athlete is to get your water just before the match and also in the match as well. The only thing is that you also need the supplements because if you just drink water, you flush out all the good thing, the magnesium and the other things that you need in order to prevent cramps, you know, and things like that.
And hydration is also very important, of course, when you're competing in various temperatures, that's really critical to make sure that their body is always ready for that optimal performance. To prevent injury in my sport, hockey, which is a very tough sport, and yoga is something that our team has incorporated into our workout routine. We always spend at least 15 minutes warming up prior to any practice or competition and 15 minutes cooling down. And that's, I think, really important.
I do my warm-up 40-45 minutes minimum. Such a great protection from the injury, particularly for the kids because they're just growing up. So don't stop your training without warm-up. This is my words.
When the difference between success and failure can be measured in tenths of a second, today's athletes face some of the toughest challenges they've ever had. Having the right facts in front of you can make a big difference.
It's not only about being here for the sport and winning, it's about making friends and learning what to make everything better in the future, because having not a healthy lifestyle makes everything harder for you in the future. So now learning all these things is so good that you know what to do and how to do it and become a better athlete.
Remember, balance your diet. Carbohydrates before competition, proteins after. Don't forget to hydrate your body. And stretch out before you practice.
I've learned a lot here in Singapore.